After seeing a tour of my home network, many of my viewers have asked to see a video explaining how to install a network jack into the wall. So here you go. Okay, so we're standing in front of an unfinished wall, and the reason I wanted you to see this is because there's no sheetrock on this side, so you'll know exactly what you're up against. Now, if you look up at the top, you'll see this is what's called the top plate, and there's going to be always at least two tubophores up there. Sometimes there may be three. And so you've got quite a bit you'll have to drill through.
It's important to consider that in most cases you will only be able to use an interior wall. In most cases, the roof line will prevent you from being able to reach the top plate of the exterior wall. And even if you could, the roof line would be in the way of the drill. And even if you could overcome that, the wall would be filled with insulation, so there's no way to feed the wire down. You'll need to go to the hardware store and pick up one of these old work boxes. You'll also need a network jack and plate. So the first thing you'll need to do is verify the cable you have is long enough to reach. You can approximate by running it on the ground floor.
Okay, because of the way this room is shaped and the living room is taller than the rest of the attic, you've got a smaller little short wall here. Once we remove that, you'll see the top plate that I was talking about, and we're going to have to drill through that.
You'll need to use a stud finder and mark the studs on the wall. I like to use masking tape to mark where the studs are. Normally, when people are searching for studs, it's because you want to screw something into them. However, in this case, we're trying to avoid them. If there are any nearby outlets of any kind, go ahead and take off the plate so you can measure how far the box is from the floor. This way, you can be sure your new box lines up with the existing ones. I just use another piece of masking tape to help me out. So, to mark your place on the wall, turn the box around backwards and find the little marker holes and make four little dots on the wall. Once you have your dots, you can draw a square on the wall. Now take a razor blade and begin to cut a hole in the wall. This is a learned skill, and it just takes some practice. I usually just go over the same lines several times, alternating the direction. Eventually, it will go all the way through the wall. Once you remove the piece of wall, you should be able to stick your hand in there and find the cable that you dropped down the wall. Now you can install your old work wall box. The next step is to strip the insulation off of the Cat5 cable. Then separate out the colored pairs and try to straighten them out to some extent. Next, you can use your fingers to align the colored wires onto the network jack. Once you're sure they're all in the right place, use a punch tool to properly terminate these wires. It should look like this when you're all done. Now you can mount the jack into the wall plate and push any excess wire back into the wall. Once you mount the plate to the wall, you are essentially done.
One more thing about that exterior wall situation, it is actually possible to do.
When I first got an electric car, it was necessary to run a 240-volt wire to the charging dock from the breaker box. But the breaker box is on an exterior wall, so I had to cut the sheetrock so that I could have access to run the wire up into the attic. I've been too lazy to repaint the wall after doing this, so it is possible, but not much fun.
Well, I hope you liked the video. I would just like to point out that the house that I was showing in the video was not actually my house. It was actually a family member's house. They bought a smart TV and wanted to be able to connect it up to their home network, and so I decided to run a network jack for them. Now, I had been planning to put this off probably until October because, hey, we live in Texas. You don't want to get up into an attic in the middle of July in Texas. Fortunately, we had this cold front come through this weekend, and I woke up Sunday morning and it was 68 degrees outside and raining, and so I decided this will be a good time to get up there and do that that network jack install. So you got to have this one a little bit early. All right, well, tell me what you'd like to see in the next video, and until next time, see you later.